Hi, welcome to Microsoft Build 2018. I'm Jeff Sakowitz, a program manager on Microsoft Graph. In this video, I'll show you how you can use Microsoft Graph to build custom workflows to help automate user and group management in Azure Active Directory. I'll start by explaining what Microsoft Graph is to help give you some context. Then, I'll go over some useful Azure AD data that's exposed in Microsoft Graph. And finally, I'll show you how you can use it to build powerful workflows and automate complex business processes. So what is Microsoft Graph? If I were to give it a textbook definition, I would say that it's a unified REST API and comprehensive developer experience for integrating with the data and intelligence exposed by Microsoft services. But what does this actually mean? Microsoft Graph is your one-stop shop for accessing data, relationships, and insights across Microsoft 365. It's a REST API that lets you build rich applications by integrating with services that are used by over 100 million active users. These services include Azure Active Directory, SharePoint, OneDrive, Outlook, Teams, Intune, Windows, and more. There's also some exciting new security APIs, and even APIs built specifically for the education space. All in all, there are over 8 trillion resources available in Microsoft Graph. Line of business developers can use Microsoft Graph to build apps that work inside their organizations. And ISVs can use it to build SaaS apps for their customers. But it's not just for developers. IT admins and other power users can leverage Microsoft Graph using tools like Azure Functions, Flow, Power Apps, PowerShell, and Graph Explorer. Now let's talk about Azure Active Directory. This is the identity and access management service and directory that's used by every organization in Office 365 and Azure. Over 15 million organizations with 1 billion users use it, including 90% of Fortune 500 companies. There are also nearly 500,000 third-party apps integrated with Azure AD today. There's a lot of useful Azure AD data that's exposed through Microsoft Graph. This includes user profiles, groups, including group membership information and APIs for checking group and role membership, organization details, role information, such as directory roles and privilege identity management. There's also APIs to facilitate B2B collaboration using our invitation manager. There's domains, applications, administrative units, devices, synchronization tasks, and more. Hopefully this is sparking some ideas for how you can use Microsoft Graph to integrate Azure AD with your applications. A few examples of things you can build include user onboarding and provisioning apps, group management and compliance tools, custom business workflows, automated security runbooks. And by the way, all of this is done securely since Microsoft Graph honors conditional access policies and all the other awesome security functionality of the underlying Azure AD platform. Now we'll dig into a few specific workflows and I'll show you some examples of the calls that could be made to Microsoft Graph for each scenario. Imagine that your company or one of your customers' companies has a series of standard onboarding steps that occur every time a new user is hired. Instead of having a human walk through those steps manually, wouldn't it be nice if this process could be automated and that person's time could be freed up? Microsoft Graph can help. So first things first, when the new hire comes in, you can create a user object by posting to the /users endpoint and set some basic attributes for that person. You can also assign them some licenses, set their manager, and set up a device. So you can provision a mobile device, and then you can mark that user the owner of the device. And then you could follow up to this by registering that device to Intune, with Intune, setting up some device policies, conditional access policies that are based on that device, so on and so forth. You can also authorize the user to have access to certain resources that they get access to by being a member of certain groups. And you could have some business logic in the background of this app that automatically assigns people to groups based on what department they're in or who their manager is. And you could also have some automatic role assignment happen. If this person's a member of the help desk, you might want to assign them to a limited admin role, or they might be a global admin as well. Now imagine that the same person who was previously manually onboarding new employees also needed to do something similar anytime a user changed departments. Let's take a look at what Microsoft Graph can do to help here too. And again, we'll go through some pseudo REST calls. So first things first, Microsoft Graph can help you update the user's department by patching the user object. And then you can go ahead and get the user's current manager. And you'll see why we got this later, so we're going to store that for now. and then we're going to set the new manager. Now, in the background, this app, or a dedicated app that's tracking changes to users, could monitor for this sort of department change and take a set of automated steps when that happens. So you're going to use Delta Query for this, which is our change tracking API. And when Delta Query tells you that a department change has happened, you can go ahead and remove the user from any groups that were giving them access to resources that they should no longer have access to, and then add them to some new groups, and possibly add them to roles. If they weren't an admin before, maybe they are now, so you can add them to a directory role. Now you can take this a step further and actually start to save time for the user and their manager and make things more efficient for everybody involved by doing some automation around the handoff of their work to somebody on their old team. So you can use some Insights APIs to see what the user's working on, look at the tasks that have been assigned to them in Planner, and then you can use all this information, bundle it up, and create an email that goes out to the user's old manager, new manager, and possibly somebody taking over their work with a nice itemized, you know, list of tasks that have links to detailed plans in Planner to, you know, let people know what the user was on point for that's still in progress, and make sure nothing gets dropped on the floor. Now, there's an additional enhancement that you could make to both of the workflows that we talked about previously. And you know, as you likely know, it's good security hygiene to make sure that there's as few persistent administrators in the organization as possible. Ideally, people would request admin access just in time, only as needed, and then they would be demoted from being an admin as soon as they're done with whatever task requires that level of access. And as you might already know, Privileged Identity Management, or PIM, is super useful for this today. And PIM exposes a series of APIs in Microsoft Graph that can help you automate this process and build PIM-powered workflows directly into your existing apps and new apps you're building. So instead of adding someone persistently to a directory role with the call you can see right now, you could use PIM to add them as a candidate for a role, and they could request that just in time. And they could be demoted from the role when they're done with whatever their task is. And this could be super helpful in, for example, to build in line to a help desk app, and that where people occasionally need to do privileged things like perform password resets and other things like that. Now let's imagine that the same company has some special group naming rules that they need, and they want to make sure that all their groups stay in compliance of these naming conventions. And they want to make sure this is kept in check across the entire organization. So again, Delta Query can be helpful here, and you can also use webhooks to optimize this as well. And webhooks and Delta Query are generally used better together. So to start, you can read all groups in the tenant and get a Delta token. This will let you scan all the existing groups and make sure they're compliant, and then get a Delta token that'll be used later to actually come back and learn what's changed to the set of groups that exist in the tenant. Once you reach steady state with Delta Query and you've scanned all the existing groups and checked them for compliance, you can open up a webhook subscription by posting to the subscriptions entity. And in the body of this post, you'll provide a URL where you want your application to get notified whenever there's a change that it should be aware about. So then when that happens, Microsoft Graph will reach out and send a little poke to your webhook's endpoint. This won't contain any data. It'll just let you know that there is some new data to be retrieved. And you can call back using that Delta token and get back only the groups that have changed. And this could be new groups, updated groups, or deleted groups. And now you don't have to filter through all the groups in the entire tenant and rescan them all or do some sort of diff calculation to, you know, mark what groups you've already checked. And then if you find some non-compliant groups in that list, you can go ahead and either automatically patch them to update the group name or ask somebody for input and ask them, you know, what a group name should be within the compliance requirements and go ahead and make that update. In this video, you've seen how you can use Microsoft Graph to automate complex business processes and build custom workflows for user and group management, and how it can help you squeeze every ounce of value out of Azure Active Directory and the rest of Microsoft 365. To learn more, check out our documentation at graph.microsoft.com and try out our samples on GitHub. Be sure to tell us about your projects on Twitter and ask us any questions you have on Stack Overflow. Thanks for watching.